He is an NBA superstar, a standout in this year's playoffs. The 6'11" center for the Houston Rockets is many things, but Dwight Howard is adding one more thing to that list, an advocate for change. He traveled to Charleston, South Carolina this week. He sat alongside members of families and others mourning the loss of 9 beautiful lives. He tweeted a picture of the program, an NBA All-Star. Dwight Howard joins me now to talk about why he went to Charleston. Thank you for being here, sir. I appreciate it.
Well, thanks for having me.
I think this is the first time I will ever look taller than you, my friend, because you look a little shorter, a little shorter than me in that camera shot. Thank you for doing this. Let me ask you this. You went to Charleston. What motivated you to go to Charleston and meet with some of these families?
Oh, well, there were a series of events that have happened, you know, throughout the year. And, you know, I wanted to be there so bad, you know, and we had, you know, the season going on and we're in the middle of the playoffs. And this time we had just got out and it hurt, you know, to see the things that had happened in Charleston. And, you know, it just broke my heart because I just felt like that could have been me. It could have been my friends. It could have been my pastor. It could have been anybody. And I wanted to be there and show my support. And just to show people that, you know, we need change in our society.
You have started a campaign called Breathe Again. Let's talk about that. What's your mission?
Oh, well, my mission is to really just change people's lives. You know, I think that all of us, you know, as a society, we need to breathe again. We need to step back and take a look at ourselves and our lives. And if we want change, we need to be that change. And we got to have hope. You know, we need some type of hope, some type of bright light to make us want to move forward. And I just feel like there's so much hate going around in this world that, you know, needs to stop, you know. And I just hate to see the things that have happened to our society because of, you know, hate. And hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can. And I just want to spread as much love as possible to everybody around the world. And that's why I started this campaign.
I want to direct people. I want to direct people, you have a website, wewillbreathe.com, for people to go and learn more about this, because you've said you want people to point to the solution instead of pointing to the problem. What we heard this morning from the Reverend Norvell Goff at Emmanuel AME Church, take a listen to what he said.
A lot of folk expected us to do something strange and to break out in a riot. Well, they just don't know us.
What's your reaction to that? He says, you know, people expected us to react differently than we did as a community.
Well, I think the way that we all need to react to different problems, you know, we have to react with love. You know, it's so easy to react with our fists or with rioting or with guns, but when we react with love, it just sends the right message. We show people that, you know, violence is not the answer. And I know a lot of people are fed up with a lot of things that have happened. But, you know, we're not going to get rid of those problems until we face them head on and we do out of love. You know, nothing can come out of evil and hate. But when you do things out of the good of your heart and out of love, you know, things will happen and things will get better. And, you know, I just want things to get better because there's so much stuff that go on in our society. And it just hurts me to see how these kids have to grow up now with everything that's going on. We are, you know, those examples for our children. And I think we got to be a better example. And so these kids can see that love is the only way we can drive out all this hate.
It broke my heart to wake up Thursday morning to this news of what happened in Charleston, just like I think it broke the hearts of America. Are you hopeful?
I am, you know, but I think we all got to do it together. We got to stop pointing a finger. We got to look at ourselves and how can we change? You know, if we want our society to be better, you know, we got to be that change, you know, for our kids. They have to see that change coming from us. You know, our eyes are the windows of our soul. You know, what we see is what we become. Mm. If we see love and we see all the right things, then, you know, our society will change. You know, so I'm all about change. Nobody's perfect, but if we could find a way to become better people and treat people better and treat people with love and respect, our world would be a better place.
You know, we certainly saw it play out in the beautiful services across Charleston this morning. Dwight Howard, thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
Good to have you on. For all of you, again, you can check out this campaign at wewillbreathe.com. Dwight Howard, we appreciate it. Of course.